today we are bringing together five bright young girls who have never met. Our goal? To create an environment of acceptance, where they can have a candid conversation about the many pressures young girls face. So, the questions and facts that I'm going to hit you with today, I know you're well aware of, that a lot of girls your age and younger feel a lot of pressure from their school, from the television, from social media, to be a certain way.
A lot of the people at my school are worried about getting fat or something. They want to look a certain way, and they're not pretty if they don't look that way.
If you're like really smart, some people might make fun of you because smart isn't the cool or smart isn't like the pretty. It's just not really fair.
I think it's hard not to compare yourself to some point because you see these perfect models, right? And we're just so used to these high expectations of what we're supposed to look like. So, I mean, I'll catch myself looking at the magazine and being like, I wish I had her skin, you know?
There's always like that mainstream that I'd always wanted to kind of be like, and I kind of was like, oh, like I'd love to have lighter skin, and I wish I had blue eyes or something.
I have some stats I want to read to you.
Okay.
One being 50% of girls in grade 6 are on a diet.
That's terrible. That's absolutely yes.
And I'm sure you know some young women who are going through these struggles. More than half of all girls wish they were someone else.
Maybe a lot of pressure is put on them from social media.
9 out of 10 girls say they feel pressure by the media to look a certain way, in particular to be thin. Is this something you see in your own life and in your social circles?
Yes, it is. I think the whole thing about being thin, though, is that you can see somebody that's thin, but they may not be healthy. Or you can see somebody that's overweight and they may be healthy. And I think health is something that's really hard to judge on the outside.
Do you think there's a way that we can, as women, we can shield ourselves from some of this imagery?
I think so, but it's so hard to shield yourself from something like that when it's all over social media.
But confidence comes from a lot of different places, right? It comes from within, it comes from your parents, but it can also come or be taken away by the things we see out in the world. Do you see things sometimes out in the world that make you feel less confident about yourself?
Like stuff like when like bulliers, like people that bully you. Someone used to bully me. Mm-hmm. And I didn't really like it. Mm-hmm. And she used to call me names and stuff. It didn't make me feel good. Think of all the positive stuff, not negative. Or don't be around negative people.
That is it. That's huge. I didn't learn that till I was like 30 years old, girl. That's so incredibly wise.
Friend Tanya, you have the most spunky sense of style, and we really adore your sense of fun.
To our new friend Maya, you have the most adorable smile, and we really appreciate your confidence because it is charming.
To our new friend Cassidy, you have the most kind eyes, and we really love your personality because it's warm-hearted.
To our new friend Zoe, you have the most chill vibe, and we all would really appreciate your confidence because it is inspiring.
To our new friend Natasha, you have the most calm, compassionate personality, and we really love your sense of style because it's so cute. We all agree that your smile is warm-hearted and bright.
Five girls, five perspectives, one common journey. finding beauty in themselves and each other, to simply be you.